Thank you guys so much for coming back to the show. I am here today with Pastor Mercy Favor. And this is my first time meeting her. We have a mutual friend, and that is Eric Meredith. Eric knows everybody. I don't know anyone he doesn't know. And he's been a great help to me over the time of doing this show, just to introduce me to ministers and ministries in the city I would never know about. So that's Mercy Favor is one of those ministers. And she has a church in Ongadigan Street. So we're going to find out about that ministry here in a minute. And also she is from Kenya. Mercy, why don't you tell us a little bit about your salvation? How did you find the Lord? How did the Lord find you? What was happening in your life that you found the Lord? Please.
Yeah, as Corey has said, I was a very stubborn girl as I grew up. And it happened that also I was an orphan, total orphan. My mother and father died and left when I was 5 years. And I went through a lot, but I also lacked love. And it happened that I was so bright in school, but very cheeky. So in that midst of all those things, being naughty and just doing things the way I wanted, I finished school and then got married at a very early age, looking for love. But my marriage was so challenging. And I was nearly wanted to commit suicide. And that is when the Lord sent some people to come and preach to me in the house. And then I accepted the Lord. And once I accepted the Lord, after 2 months, the Lord filled me with the Holy Spirit. And there was a lot of change in my life. There's a lot of, I gained a lot of power, heavenly power. And I knew that the power of the enemy has no power over me. Yes. And to say the truth, hospital was home because I was already married with kids. So every week we were in hospital, me or my children. But the time I got born again, God took that away.
Amen.
Sickness from my family disappeared and was terminated.
Yes.
So that's why I understood there's power in God.
Yes.
And that's how God got me.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you said it was 2 months after you got saved. You said you were filled with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
What happened? How did this happen?
Okay. So when I was, as I said, I was a very stubborn girl or woman. So when I got born again, there's a sister who came from one of the towns in Kenya called Nakuru.
Yes.
So he came and said he wanted to do deliverance to people that want it. So, and by then I was 2 weeks old. I had just delivered my child and I was 2 weeks old.
Yeah.
But because of what I've passing through, I said, I had heard from the church that you can test God.
Yeah.
So I said, at this time, let me test this God.
Yeah.
Because I have so much demons in me. So I decided to go on this try first, 3 days. So people said, you are going to die. You, with 2 weeks old, 1 week with child, you can't. But I said, no, I want to test God. So I fasted the first day.
Yeah.
They were telling us, I was a very new person, I don't know how to pray, but they were telling us how to pray. The second day, they told us to talk. So I left my husband on the bed and I kneeled down. I started praying, and then from nowhere, I started speaking in language that I don't understand. Nobody laid hands on me.
Wow.
So I started speaking, and then my husband said, I told you don't go to that church. You see, you are mad, you are mad, you are talking something. But to me, I was just continuing. When I went, that is how I got baptized with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Yeah. After the second day of dry fasting.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So you're filled in the Spirit, and then you say you know and realize there is power.
There's power. Because day, as I, we lived, I was a neighbor to a witch doctor.
Yeah.
And he did not give
us. You lived by a witch doctor.
Yes. A witch doctor. Okay. And he didn't give us any break.
Okay.
everything was just nasty.
Yeah.
Afflictions after one another.
Yeah.
So when I got that, things could cry on the, like at night, you could hear things walking, things crying, like women, like children, like men. So we was and at no peace.
Yeah.
So what happened? The day I was filled by the Holy Spirit and I started speaking in tongues,
yes,
those things stopped.
Wow.
That was the end of those things at night.
Wow.
And then, to say the truth, one day I met with this witch doctor on the way.
Yes.
So I was with a friend. So he wanted to greet me. He greeted me, greeted my friend, and then he wanted to pass in between me and the friend. Okay. He fell down. He fell down, and then I told my friend, let's go.
Yeah.
Because, and from that time, this witch doctor, if he could see me coming, he diverges.
Wow.
Yep.
And that's because the authority
the
in
authority
you.
The authority and power and the anointing up. I was powerful. I don't know how I can explain it.
Yes. Now, okay. We're going to visit your testimony in a minute. Or I should say your transition.
Yeah.
To Canada. We can visit that in a minute. But now, right now, in the present, as of 2012, you are ministering at a church in Gottingen Street. What is the address of the church?
2358
Gottingen Street.
Yes.
Tell us about that and what is available. You say you pray for people.
Yeah.
What does that mean? And what do you pray for them? And what happens when you pray for them, please?
Yeah. So thank you so much. So Jordan, first of all, the church is called Jordan Love Anointed Ministry.
Yes.
And why did we come up with that name? Jordan is, you know, Jordan is a river in Israel. Uh-huh. Jesus is love. Anointing is power. And then ministry international means we are here for nations.
Yes.
That is why we took Jordan Love Anointed Ministry.
Yes.
So because the river in Jordan, you see so much was done in River Jordan, eh?
Yeah.
Love is Christ.
Yes.
And then international, all nations are welcome.
Yes.
And anointing. The anointing is what makes the difference.
Yes.
So at this church we have I got it from a previous pastor that passed on.
Yes.
So I took it from Richard Mumba.
Okay.
And then that pastor I loved so much. And so what we do at church, we believe prayer is the key principle.
Yes.
To open heavens.
Yes.
So the church is for prayer, healing, and deliverance.
Yes.
So we have three prayer meetings Monday. Wednesdays is included by plus the Bible study, and then Saturday's prayer, and then we have services on Sundays 10:30 to 12:30 or 1.
Okay.
But mostly we engage in prayer.
Yeah.
Though I know many people here in Canada do not like prayer, but that ministry, I have delivered. So many people have come to me, like they are demonized, they are whatever. I have helped them to come through. Yes. I don't help them to stay at church. I just want them to be free.
Yes.
So I have prayed for thousands and thousands of people.
Wow.
If I could be like a church wanting people to stay or people come and stay, I could be having over 5,000 people.
Yes.
Because since I came, prayer has been my key.
Yes.
And people come in, they say that whatever the challenges they are going through, we pray for healing, pray for deliverance, and God has been moving.
Now, can you explain to the folks that are watching today, what does the word deliverance even mean? Some people don't even know.
Yeah.
What now, when that happens, what is happening? What tell us, what is happening?
So, it's one thing to be born again.
Yeah.
Then there's another thing to be delivered.
Mm.
That is why when God touched, there's a man in the Bible, God touched and he said, what do you see? He said, I see men as trees. Mm. And God touched him the second time. Then he said, I see men as men.
Mm.
So it's as I said, one thing to get born again, and there's another thing to be delivered.
Mm.
Because we come from different backgrounds.
Mm.
Like you can be born again, but you have anger in you. Mm. You can be born again and you still carry bitterness, unforgiveness, lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, pride of life. So when deliverance means when you come, we want to make you pray so that all those things that hinder you to access God or be in the presence of God, you are delivered from them.
Yes.
You are set free from them. Mm. So deliverance is completely being set free. We don't argue that you are born again.
Mm.
But there are people who are born again, but they're still immoral.
Yeah.
So you need to be a second touch from the Lord so that these things, you walk free from them.
Yes.
Yeah, that's how I can explain.
They come into your church.
Yes.
They know that you will pray.
Yeah.
And they ask for help.
Yes.
And you pray for them through until they feel something is leaving their heart.
Yeah. You see, you remember when Jesus called these people and the demons were speaking. I have had demons speaking to me.
Mm.
So they say, why are you tormenting us at this time? Or this is our temple. He invited us in. So you have to know the word of God to cast them out. There are some that goes out slowly, silently, but most of them want to be aggressive.
Yes.
So you, with the power and authority you have, you can silence them. And
And that's what you're seeing happen.
Yeah.
And that life is changed.
It's changed, completely changed. And because why? It happened to me.
Yes.
It happened to me because when I was at home, I got born again, as I've said.
Yes.
And then when I went through that 3 days prayer and fasting, prayer and fasting, the 4th day, now we went into this deliverance. And that set me free because things that came out of me were just the anger, the resentment, the rejection that I passed through all. So they were just coming out. And I never remained the same. After that touch, I was just escalating in the anointing.
Yes.
Yeah. So some of us, sometimes we are hindered to move from one level to level because of what we are carrying from the inside.
Yes.
Yeah. So inside is more important than outside.
That is a powerful
inside
statement. Amen. Yeah.
God heals from the inside out.
Yes.
But most people always want to show us their outside appearance as nothing. You have from, if inside is okay, outside is okay.
Yes.
Out of the heart comes what?
Yes.
The
issues of life.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's very true.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you mentioned that you pray for people to be healed.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody comes and they, I don't know, maybe heart trouble, I don't know, maybe something, anything physically wrong with them, they injured themselves. Mm-hmm. Is it something you have seen God actually heal?
Okay. Let me, I'll just give an example of one person.
Yeah.
There's a brother who came from Edmonton.
Yeah.
And then he had been sick for so many, many years.
Mm.
Like winter time, he couldn't go out.
Mm.
So he came, and that one was simple. The Lord, he came in, we fellowshiped with him for some time. And then one day I was on the pulpit and I was fasting.
Yeah.
And then the Lord told me, just tell that man to say, By the stripes of Jesus, I was healed 21 times.
Yeah.
So I called the man. I don't want to disclose the name. Mm. I called the man and I said, this is what the Lord is saying.
Mm.
And then confessed this to him. I led him. He confessed 21 times. And that was total healing.
Wow.
Never again.
Wow.
That was the first winter he was out in Halifax. He had never been out of winter. During winter, he's depressed down.
Yes.
And then that winter he was out, he came and testified in church.
Wow.
Then there's another woman, a woman came in.
Yes.
This woman is he's been having like a bestiality sleep.
Yes.
And spiritual husbands.
Yes.
You call them the water spirits that sleep with him at night.
Yeah.
So he came, she came in, we helped her until those things left.
Wow.
They left and the woman now goes to another church in Halifax. He came back and thanked us for making her free.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, that is so okay. Now I have a big question. Mm. Can anybody go to your church?
Yeah,
is it a church where somebody who maybe is not from any part of Africa, mm-hmm. just somebody who, let's say, grew up here, mm-hmm. can they come to your church and be a part of it?
Yes. Why am I saying so? This church is international. Yeah. That is why we say Jordan Love Ministry International. Yeah. So anyone, and in fact at my church, we have white people, yeah. we have Africans, we have, there was a time the Indians were there, but he left.
Yeah.
So it's multicultural, my church. It doesn't, yeah. it's not specifically, I am a Kenyan, yeah. but I think I have, the only three Kenyans I have is like people that are related to me.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyone is welcome. Yeah. This is the Church of Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ is for multitudes.
Mercy, do you love this country? Has God put a love in you for this country and for these people, Canada, Canadians?
Yeah. This country, I came by, I'm God sent. Yeah. And when I came here, I have done a lot of things on the ground which I can't say.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah.
Done a lot of prayer works here, yeah. and they're still waiting for God to manifest himself.
Yes.
But I love Canada.
Yes.
The only thing that sometimes I wonder why people here don't love God, that is something that has been in me. But actually, I love Canada. Why? Because yes. I'm God sent here to do something.
Yes. Yes.
And once I came to Canada, when I reached in Halifax, this is what God told me. This is the eastern gate of Canada.
Wow.
And the glory will move from here towards, and that's why I have planted you here.
Wow. Yeah. I have heard other ministers having a very similar word from God.
Yeah.
Now, I want you to speak into the body of Christ that is in Nova Scotia, maybe Canada. And has the Lord given you anything in your heart for the church here in this province, or maybe in the city? Or have you heard anything that you would like to, you feel free that you could share with people today?
So, there was that time, 2014, I was in a ministry of pastors. And I prepared a document. I prepared a document on unity. I presented it in the pastors' meeting. So, the Lord's agenda for this Nova Scotia is unity of purpose. People here, pastors are not one. Pastors are like everyone with his own congregation. So unless, the Lord told me, unless there's unity, people will come here and say, we have brought God, we have done this and that, but I'm not there. So one time they had a meeting somewhere in one of the churches, and then I was part of it. And then the Lord, they were saying, we're handing over Canada to Jesus. But they were using somebody. But the Lord says, where is, they took the First Nation people. And then the Lord asked me, Mercy, where is the African Canadian? Even them, they were just mistreated as the nation, the First Nations. So what I'm saying is that there's no unity. God is lacking unity of purpose.
Okay.
That is why. So I called other pastors and all the other preachers in this land to work towards unity. So because where there's unity, God commands a blessing. And the devil knows that where there's, that's why he fights unity. You can even see how the devil fights unity in marriages, because he knows where there is unity. So what I can say, if we can work towards unity, leave all our denominations behind and come back. Because in Africa, that's why the churches in Africa are strong. Pastors work together.
Yes.
Yeah.
So this has to happen here.
It has to happen
here. We have to have ministers who, and churches who are working together here, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Yes, that is an excellent word. Okay, now, I was going to ask you, was there unique problems that you see here that we struggle with here in this problem? I think you just said it. It's with unity.
Unity,
yeah. Yeah, that's a major problem.
That's the major problem.
Yeah. Yes. And how the enemy wants to continue to keep us from
separate.
Being unified.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, could you tell us a little bit about your call to come here? We're going to leave off where you were filled in the Holy Spirit mm-hmm. in Kenya mm-hmm. After 2 days of fasting prayer. Mm-hmm. And then from there, how did you get here?
Okay, so from there, after some time, as I said, I was on fire. Mm. And then I continued that way, So people started, ministers of God or men of God started speaking in my life that you are a woman of nations. God is going to take you to nations. But I could despise myself because the way I was. Huh? And then to cut the story short, in 2012, God used another sister in the U.S. to connect me to Cody Institute.
Yeah.
And then I found myself in Canada.
Wow.
And as I came to Canada, I finished whatever I was doing in Centifax or Cody.
Yeah.
And then I moved to Halifax.
Yes.
I stayed in the shelter through the Halifax Refugee Clinic.
Mm.
And then somebody took me to his house for 9 months. And that is how I found myself in Jordan Love Anointed Ministry by joining together with the late Richard Mumba.
Okay.
And then he died in this October.
Yeah.
Then I wanted to close up the ministry, but God says you have the anointing.
Mm.
And before I finish that, why I knew God had called me, this is what happened. So when this man died, when the man of God died, I say, I'm a student. Huh? I have no job. I have nothing. And the bills were there.
Yeah.
And in fact, the man had been told that he's supposed to pay our electric bills for 10 months. But 10 months he had not paid.
Ooh.
So, and then he used to pay rent from his pocket, like work money.
Yeah.
So what made me know that God is with me and he wants me in that ministry?
Yeah.
So when I accepted it, one day I came, because I usually go to that church every morning, even if I'm in school, I have to go there.
Yeah.
So one day I came and I reached at the door. But before then, the Lord told me, why are you arguing on my behalf?
Mm.
Why are you as if I don't have what I have?
Yeah.
So I listened. So when I went in the morning for morning glory, as I reached at the door, the Lord, I had the voice of the Lord telling me, open the mailbox.
Mm.
I disobeyed. When I disobeyed, the voice came, open the mailbox.
Yeah.
I opened.
Yeah.
And I found an A4 envelope this size.
Yeah.
I opened. Inside the envelope, no name, nothing, $1,490.
Wow.
And then the Spirit told me, this is for the church, go and put on the account.
Yeah.
I went faithfully. I have been very faithful with church money. I never, whatever got. So after that week, the next week again, I had the same voice.
Yes.
I opened the mailbox.
Mm.
In that mailbox was $600 written mercy.
Yeah.
$890 for the church.
Yeah.
Now, the same envelope, I said, God, you are with me.
Yeah.
And then when I went to the landlord to pay, now to start paying the bills, whatever, I reached there and they asked me, have you started paying your electric bills? I said, no. You said, end of this month. They said that we have waived it. And then they asked me, how much rent are you paying for your house? I said, $550. Well, how many months have you paid for $550? I said, 6 months. They said, we are giving you $300 right now.
Mm.
That is a miraculous like that.
Wow.
So God started paying the money himself without telling anyone.
Wow.
Miraculous money.
Wow.
That is how God now made me to understand, God, you want me to be here. That was a sign to show that I am in the right place.
Yes.
Yeah. One thing I want to talk to my fellow Christians, saints like me, ambassadors like me, let us be committed to this Lord.
Amen.
Because compromise has made the church what it is.
Yes.
Deception has made the church what it is.
Yes.
People despising the word of God, wanting to do things the way they want it.
Yes.
They don't want to follow the word of God, and then they start blaming God.
Yes.
That where is God?
Yeah.
But specifically me,
yeah,
as I followed God, yeah, I've lived, I came to Canada without a single cent.
Yes.
And my children and I went through school. We left without any debt,
yeah,
through faith.
Yes.
People just came.
Yeah.
And when I came to Canada, my brother, there's a verse that God gave me.
Yeah.
You can, Isaiah 43 verses 4.
Yeah.
Because I've loved you,
yeah,
you're precious in my eyes. I'll give people for you and men for you.
Amen.
And it started working. So what am I saying? Let us be committed to the Lord.
Amen.
Because our help cometh from the Lord, nothing else, the maker of heaven and earth, and he has a script for each one of us.
Amen.
So once your determination makes,
amen,
the percentage you are determined to serve God,
yeah,
is the percentage God comes to you.
Amen.
So God is real.
Yes.
And my brothers and sisters, let us be committed to him.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. That's a beautiful word.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Mercy Favor. That was a beautiful word. And I just want you guys to know that the address of the ministry and any details she wishes to give will be right below in the description of this video. So if you would like to contact her to come and speak at your church or at your special meeting that you might be having, or if you'd like to get in touch with her beforehand, before making her a part of a ministry work you would like to put forward to her, please just write her at that email, and she will get back in touch with you. And we're just so thankful to God. Again, I can say from my heart that God has brought another gift, because that's what ministries and ministers are. They're a gift to the body of Christ. And God has brought you as a gift to the body of Christ here in our country. And we're just so thankful to God for you. Thank you for obeying the Lord. Thank you for coming. Thank you for obediently continuing in this ministry. And may God just continue to make you so fruitful and a blessing to the nations. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you all. And we will see you again next week. God bless.